Have you ever needed to resort to a padding hack in CSS to set an aspect ratio on an element? Well, I certainly have, and way too many times, but not for a while now, because we have an aspect ratio property in CSS that is supported in all modern browsers. In this video, I will show you how it works, and I will outline some typical use cases where you might find it helpful. Let's dive in. Alright, the aspect ratio is usually defined as a proportional relationship between width and height. We usually think about that in terms of images, videos, maybe display sizes or screen sizes. And in CSS, aspect ratio allows you to create elements that maintain proportional dimensions regardless of where you placed an element. And this essentially means that regardless of the screen size or regardless of the parent container size, the element dimensions will be consistent. For replaced elements, like images or videos, for example, this works out of the box. I have an image here, and this is defined as an image element with the source. I don't have a width or height set on this element. That's an important thing to note. And in CSS, I'm setting the width of this element to 100 and height to auto. And if we resize the screen, you're gonna see that the image is not distorted and it's visible in its entirety always. This means that this element maintains an internal aspect ratio that works as you would expect, but this is not the case for replaced elements. So for example, if we were to create a div element, let's do this right here. I have a simple div element and I'm setting its width and height and the background image to set to the exactly the same picture like I have here. And you see here that this image is cut off. It's not working as you would expect. And if I resize, the aspect ratio is effectively changing, going from a landscape orientation to basically a portrait one. The way to go around this is to use something called a padding hack. And padding hack works in a way that you set a height of an element to 0 and padding top to the percentage that represents aspect ratio. Padding top in percentages is defined as the percentage of the width of the container, and for this example, 56.25 would be 16:9 aspect ratio, and you could calculate this if you divided 9 with 16 and then multiplied by 100, and you would get this number, which is essentially the aspect ratio we're looking for this image. And now, if I'm resizing the browser, you see that my image maintains the aspect ratio I wanted to maintain. But as you probably noticed, there are a number of problems with this technique, or rather a hack. And the problem number one is we're setting the height to 0, which means we cannot add any content inside because, well, there's no place to add it. The way to go around this is to add another container inside of it, position it absolutely, and then add content there, or use the before and after elements, but that's also not ideal. It's really complicated and it's not what we want to see in our code. Aspect ratio property allows us to go around that exactly as you would expect. So let's add aspect ratio to this div. And you define aspect ratio with the value that represents width and height. So in our case, this would be 16:9. And this essentially means that our preferred aspect ratio for this element would be 16:9. And the keyword here is preferred. So this is not going to be forced. Like in this case, we have width and height set. Aspect ratio will be calculated not from here, from this property, but it will be calculated from the actual dimensions of the element. And we still don't have what we expect in here. So whenever you're trying to use aspect ratio, you have to use only one dimension, either width or height. So if we remove the height here, you're gonna see that our aspect ratio will take effect and our image will look exactly as expected. It will maintain its aspect ratio. And aspect ratio actually takes two values. One is this aspect ratio that we have here, and another one is the keyword auto. And keyword auto means that we want element to actually have an aspect ratio based on the intrinsic size of the replaced element, and that is going to be applied to images and videos. So for example, if we set aspect ratio on our image here, and we're gonna set it to 4:3, just to see that it takes effect. Now our image is distorted because that's not the actual intrinsic aspect ratio, but if we add a keyword auto here, you're gonna see that our image actually takes the intrinsic aspect ratio of the image. So that is what this keyword does. And this could be useful, for example, in the cases where the source of an image might be broken or it's not loaded. And then in that case, the image would still take exactly the same amount of space as otherwise. So let's see how this works. If we break this source here, you're gonna see that our element still maintains exactly the same space in our document structure. But if we wouldn't have this, then our element would be essentially collapsed because browser cannot calculate the aspect ratio of the element that doesn't exist. And this is how the auto keyword works here. Okay, let's return this to our starting point. And this example actually shows us one of the typical use cases, or that could be turned into a typical use case, and that would be the lazy loading of images. Because when you're lazy loading images, if you're not using the browser's lazy loading attribute, you basically you set the div elements on the page, and once the image is loaded, you replace it with the actual image. And in that case, it would be really useful to have aspect ratio set on this element because it's not going to change the size and source. The browser is not going to have to recalculate layout or anything like that. So this is one of the usual use cases. And another typical use case would be with the iframes. Iframes are replaced elements, but they don't contain an intrinsic aspect ratio. So I have an iframe here with one of my latest YouTube videos where I share a couple of tips for VS Code. So check this video, link should be on the screen right now. And this iframe is defined with the width and height, width is 560 and height is 315. So you see right here, as we set the width to 100% and height to auto, that the aspect ratio of this element is changing. And again, this is not what we want. We want this element also to maintain its aspect ratio always. And we can do this again if we set the aspect ratio for this element, and we can define it exactly with the numbers that are present right here in our source, 560 to 315, and this is going to allow us to set exactly the aspect ratio we need for this element. Ideally, we would want to do something like this, where we set the aspect ratio to the attribute width and attribute height. Because if we set the attribute width and height here, that browser should be able to read the size of that element and calculate the aspect ratio based on that. But unfortunately, attribute here doesn't work in this case. It works only in content of the pseudo elements. So hopefully browsers will support this in the future, but at this point we really have to define the aspect ratio manually, or basically hard coded. And this would be another typical use case where you define the aspect ratio for your iframe, because the iframe doesn't contain the intrinsic information about its size, about the aspect ratio it should be rendered in. So using the aspect ratio here is really helpful. Another thing I want to show you here is what preferred aspect ratio really means. So in this component here, we have three cards, and if we set their aspect ratio to 43, you're going to see that they take this aspect ratio, and regardless of how we resize our window, they're going to maintain exactly the aspect ratio we want. But if we were to add more content to one of those elements, maybe like this, and if the content doesn't fit into the height of our container, into the aspect ratio we defined, the element is going to expand as you would expect, and it's not going to keep the aspect ratio. And that's why we defined the aspect ratio as preferred aspect ratio and not, well, set aspect ratio or forced aspect ratio. So that's something to keep in mind when you're working with the aspect ratio property. And lastly, I want to show you that there is actually a media query that allows you to detect aspect ratio and, well, do something to your design based on that. And this is how it works. You set the media with the aspect ratio, and I'll just change the body background here to see how it works. So if I resize my window exactly to aspect ratio of 1:1, we should see a purple background, and this is exactly where it is. So if you want to change something based on the very specific aspect ratio or the exact aspect ratio, you could use that. But there's also another two media features that you can use to target more broadly, and that would be minimum aspect ratio and maximum aspect ratio, and this is how you would define it. So in this case, if the viewport is of minimum aspect ratio of 1:1, we're going to apply this background here. So on our landscape mode, this is what we will see, and on the portrait mode, we're going to see that this does not apply. So the maximum aspect ratio will be the exact opposite and will basically be applied to the portrait mode and not to the landscape mode. Obviously, we have landscape and portrait media query that would be more suitable for this exact case. But if you want to target something more specific, something like 16:9 or something like that, then you can do that as well using the aspect ratio media query feature. And this is how aspect ratio works in CSS. It's supported in all modern browsers, but not in Internet Explorer. So if you need to support Internet Explorer, make sure to add some kind of a feature detection, maybe using the supports add rule to ensure that the visitors get the experience you intend them to have. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I hope you found this helpful. Hit that subscribe button and I will see and hear you in the next video.